Hello guys, KP Shamino here, with a new video for Fishing Planet, the European Lakes. And in 23 hours we got a competition I just see here at the top. So, I'm going to show you guys how you need to get the carp here and the tench. They are very good money makers, they fill really fast your net. I'm going to fish with the starting gear, that's a Telefloat 450 mini spin 1200, mono 0.18 and hook 2, you guys can see it at the top left. And I'm going to fish with a level 3 feeder setup, because this is a level 3 area. Tench, they like red worms. Carp, they like bread. That's a level 1. Bread with honey is a level 6, and dog balls is a level 5. So if you want to go with the other 2-1, you need to go, you need to be higher level. So you can come here first with the bread and with the red worms. You can try that and level up. Or you can just come here with the Telefloat first, and then you switch to bread with honey. You guys can decide what you want. So you guys can check it here in the shop. So if you go to the feeder rods, so you see here the Greek Pro is a level 3, so that's nice. Then the mini spin 1200. No, the Inspire Cast 2000, I need to say, it's level 4, so that's good. And then if you go with the hook, let me have a look, the hook 2. That's over here, that's level 3 too. So you guys can see it, it's a level 3 setup. Then you need to buy the sinkers, of course. That's over here too. Here are the sinkers, so that's level 3 too. And then you need to buy a leader too, of course, because now we got leaders. So you need to use mono leader, this one. So, this is level 4, now I see it. So therefore it was a little bit higher. Then you can go with this one too, then it stays a level 3. So, but be sure go with this one, it's a little bit higher in test, it's going to make life a little bit easier. So fish a little bit with the Telefloat until you're level 4 or 5, and then you can go with the best setup. So of course you can go right away with the feeder setup too, that's no problem. And then I think I'm not going to fish with chum because it's not really needed here. And there is not really a carp bait or carp chum either in the game, so you guys can see it, it's whitefish, and this is gold bait, it's small whitefish. That's There is no chum, and it's not really needed because there is no trophy and there is no unique in this lake. So you are going to fish out of the hand because you cannot put the feeder in a rod pot because the first rod pot looks at level 8. So that's what we are going to do. So now it's time to fish a little bit. So I already got some markers out. So we are going to start over here. First of all, I'm going to show you guys the tens. What is the big problem with the Telefloat? That is that you cannot throw far enough. So they are sitting in the holes. There is one big hole in the middle of this lake. So you guys can see it here. And the main problem is with the Telefloat, it's very hard to get in the hole. So that's a little bit a problem because you're on edge. That doesn't mean that you cannot get a tench or a carp, because I got the tench and the carp on the Telefloat. It works, but I cannot go far enough. So that's where you need to go, and I need to check out the Telefloat first. It's number 4, so let's go to 4. Be always aware that you... come on. Ah yeah, okay. That you are fishing on the bottom. That's very important. So we are going to do a throw. And I'm going to check out that I can get the tench. It's not easy with the Telefloat. With the feeder it's a lot easier. So you guys can see it. This is a little bit too deep. So because my bobber is straight. So what you need to do is, you just need to go a little bit more shallow. So here we go. Let's try it again. I hope that's now 2 meters, that's a nice number. Yeah, here we go. And now you need to wait. So you can get carp here too, but of course you need to switch to bread or bread with honey. Bread with honey is a new bait, but it works really well. I hope that I can get a fish, because sometimes the bites are very, very slow. You need to wait sometimes. It's possible that I'm not in the best time of the day, but it's not that hard in this lake to make nice money. I saw that right away on the test server too, when I saw the numbers on the fish. And now you need to wait. I need to look at the best time of the day, but I think there is bite. Okay, let's have a look what we get here. Be always sure if you make a new setup that you put the drag 2 or 3. So that's it's going to happen everywhere, even at higher lakes, because take it from me, you're not going to be the first guy that just make a setup, get the fish and break the setup, because you don't have a time anymore to adjust when you are pulling too much drag, and there is another bite. So it's very active. Red worms, they're the perch, like the red worms too, silver bream. The roach, I think, likes it too, and now you need to wait, because this is small fish, because a two-hook, a tench can take the two-hook really easy. So this is, at the moment, I think it's a perch that is nibbling. But I want, of course, I want to have a tench, because they pay really good money, and they are very beautiful fish. So that's already two bites, and you guys can see it. The key in the game here and in this area is, you need to check where the fish is jumping, and that are very good positions. And they stay very good positions, because those fish are not moving around. This lake is totally filled with good positions. There is a next bite. Come on, give me a tench that I can there. Yeah, that's a good bite. Yeah, it's not a bad fish check. Now I can go one drag higher. You guys can see it. Can even go a little bit higher, and this is just a perch. I was thinking it was a perch, but you can get it with this setup too. It's going to take a little bit longer. You guys can see it here on my marker, so I got here the tench. But now I'm going to show you guys it with the feeder. The feeder is a little bit easier, because you're on the bottom. You are nicely in the hole, because if you check this, that's the main problem. I will show you guys what the problem is. So if I add now a marker, you guys will see I was just okay, I think, on the edge. Do you guys see it? So, no, I'm not in the hole. Check. The marker is just outside the hole, and that's the main problem. I can, maybe if I stand here, I can get closer to it. But I think it's made that way that you are not going to get in the hole. It's possible from here, now that I see, because this distance is slightly less. So it's possible that you get, but you need to be in the hole, because there is the fish sitting. So with the feeder, the level 3 setup feeder, it's a lot easier. So what number was it again? It was number 6. So we are going to do it again. So here now you can throw nicely on the second marker. And then you are in the hole, and that's a lot easier. Yeah, that's a good throw. Jesus Christ. Okay, try number 2. Why is my dude throwing like this? Okay, let's go a little bit backwards. Okay. Okay, that's better. Okay. And what do you need to do now is, this is, first of all, you need to zoom in. So you need to zoom in, because you cannot put it in a rod pot. I already said it. So you need to wait. The key is at the top right. You guys see just under my worms, you see the quiver. That's the red. So when the quiver starts bending, that means you got a bite. But that does not mean that you need to strike. You only strike when you see your line going away. On that moment, you are going to get the fish. So if you got nibbles, 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 never strike, because you are going to strike too early. So you need to be very patient and check. Now I got the bite. Do you see it? But I'm not going to strike, because my line is not moving. So the moment that my line is moving, that means that the fish took the bait and is swimming away. On that moment, I need to strike. So that was not a good bite. So if I strike now, it was I was just a miss. So you need to be patient and you need to wait. Yeah, and there is another bite. You see it again. It's bending. This looks stronger, but still we need to wait. We need to wait. Check. My line is still not going. No, it was not a good bite. So I know you need to be patient. You need, that's because I know I did it too. The first time that I did some feeder fishing, I saw the bite and I striked. And I was like, damn, I missed it. Next time I waited a little bit longer. I striked again. But you need to wait. You need to wait a long time. You are going to check another bite. The good thing about feeder fishing is that you got a shitload of bites. But the main problem is there are a lot of small fish. And I think only the Tench is going to give a very strong bite. This is a good bite. Check, check, check. The line is going away. Did you guys see it? So it was going away, the line. And then it's time to strike. And I think this is a 10. So you need to be patient. But you saw it really good. It was going to the left. And on that moment, I know, okay, now it's time to get the fish in. And I hope this is a nice 10. No, it's a Prussian carp, check. So this is not the right fish. Okay, let's do it again. So I'm going to do one more try, but you guys saw it on the marker. This is where you need to get the tench. So it can take some time because a lot of fish like the low level baits. That's the main problem. But I wanted to make a video for guys that start this game. So I think you need to invest in the feeder setup. What is it? Maybe 1000 silver. So you can buy it and you are going to make really quick money with it. Of course, if you level up, be sure that you always buy a bigger keep net. That's the key of this game to make more money. So the moment that you see, okay, I can get a keep net that's bigger, so that you make more money every day. We need to wait again. Let's try to zoom. Yeah, that was once again not a good bite. It's a patient game, feeder fishing. So once you can do the rod pot, it's a lot easier because you can fish with like 2, 3, even 4 setups. But yeah, you need to start somewhere. It's the start is always hard, but once that you got a little bit more setups and you go to the higher levels, the money is very good because I fished in Aktuba. And to give you guys an example, a trophy sender of 3 kilogram is 1500 currency. So, and you got now a net, what is it, 300 kilograms or something. So then the money farm starts. But that's, yeah, there it goes. Do you guys see it? It was going to the right. And I don't think that the tench are biting because this is not a tench. It's a perch again. So, but that's a spot that you need to throw, guys. Just keep trying, and at some point you guys will get this fellow. So here you can see it, the tench. So the tench gives for a half a kilogram 109 currency. That's with premium, so that means that's 50 currency. So if you get 2 in one day, you paid your stay already and your travel fees. 2 tench is enough. So it goes really quick. Now we are going to the other position. The other position is the carp position. So I saw that right away. I showed you guys it on the test server too. You can fish here, of course, too, with the telescopic. But once again, you cannot make the distance. I got the carp on the telescopic too. But the feeders are a lot better. You guys can see it. So the first marker is telescopic. The second marker is the feeder. So we are going to switch now to bread. So if you want to go with the level 1 bait, you can just go with the bread. That works too. But the bread with the honey is a little bit better. So that's the new bait, but that's level 6 of course. So let's have a look that we can get the carp. So I'm going to throw over here. There we go, and it's just the same what you need to do. So you just need to wait long enough. The carp are a little bit stronger. So you guys see it now, it's 4 meters here. So I'm very in the deepest hole of the area. So we come from 2.8. So in the middle of the lake, there is the deep hole. So that's how you can see that you're throwing in the hole. So just before the weight hits the bottom, you see how deep it is on that position. And I hope that I can get the carp here. Because it's not that easy. You're fishing with one rod. If you just go with red worms in the lilies, you're going to catch a lot of more fish. Perch, silver bream, but they are very small. So one carp is like the equal of, I think, 4 or 5 silver bream. So yeah, and there, do you see the bending of the quiver? So I hope it's, let's zoom once again. No, he stopped again. So it's a small fish. I guess a roach. And you guys see it already. A lot of activity, a lot of jumping fish in this area. So you can move a little. There is another jumping fish. You can move a little bit to the right. You can move a little bit to the left. So. Yeah, and I need to wait again. It can take some time, the fishing. With the feeder. But I guess once. Yeah, there is another bite. Do you see the quiver going? Yeah, this looks. No, he stopped biting again. So it's all small fish. The two hook is just too big for that fish. So, yeah, I think that was a roach or a silver bream, one of the two. You will see it right away when it's a carp. It's like the sound of the bells going a lot higher because they are biting very strong. And if they go away, if they start biting, most of the time there is another bite. So, let's wait a little bit. Seems a good bite. Keep biting and go away, please. Come on. He keeps. Yeah, he's gone. Check. So slack on the line means that he's swimming to here too. So if the line goes away, he swims away, and this is a carp. You guys can see it right away. The fight is a lot harder. No, it's not a carp. It's a Prussian again. Jesus Christ. But yeah, it's a carp too. The Prussian, you know. So let's do another throw. I was hoping for the common or the mirror ones. So let's do a new throw and let's have a look. So let's zoom in again on the quiver. We are at the 4 meter one. So that's how you need to do it, guys. And you can make a lot of money. I'm not sure how the feeder fishing is in New York. I guess you can feeder fish with small minnows on the walleye. That's possible. So I need to check it out. Because with the feeder fishing, a lot of new stuff is opening, kind of fishing. Because you can now go with 4 rods. So I guess you can get 3 rods, all with small minnows. I'll throw them in the hole, one left, one right from the dock. And you're going to catch a lot of walleye the whole day long. So at night, it's going to give fireworks if you go like that. So if you think about old lakes, and you think because the feeder fishing works in old lakes too, the new bite system is not in the old lakes yet, but it will come. But there are so many options now that you got, it's unbelievable. And let's have a look. Nope, he stopped biting again. You are going to get a lot of bites. You guys can see it. But it's not. Sometimes you got like 2-3 carps after each other. And then it stops. Maybe that's a new system too. I'm not sure. Because at the right, you guys see that it's very active at the right now. Here at the left on my first marker, it's very active too. Maybe I need to throw a little bit to the left. A little bit to the right. But... No, that was on my marker. There is fish jumping, so it's active. Let's do a retro. So I'm going to do one more cast, guys. You guys know the position, so this is for the carp. So if you try it, you will get the carp after some time. Okay, that's a little bit further. Is it deeper than 4 meters? No, 3.5. So the first throw was in the deeper hole. Now it's a little bit more shallow. And do I already got a bite? Yeah, I got a bite, check. Right away action. So the recast was not bad. But it's small fish, it's not biting. Oh, he keeps biting. Come on, go away. No, he stopped biting. I was expecting that the bite was not strong enough. Yeah, there is already another bite again. Yeah, here we go. No, it's not a carp again. It's, I think, Crucian again, or even smaller. Oh, wait, wait, wait. No, no. Yeah, it's today the time of the Prussian. They call it Prussian here, but you guys can see it on my marker. Let's have a look. So you can see it here, young common carp on the edge. And if you go a little bit closer, I got the young mirror carp. This was with the telescopic. So you guys can see it here. If you start keep fishing in this area, this little bay in the hole, you will get at some point the carp. So that was it for the video, guys. I hope it helps a lot of new players in the game. So with the level 3, you can go right away with feeder fishing level 3. It's very fun. You're going to make nice money. You guys can see it here. So I already got, how many fish do I got? 13, 874, that's 470. Of course, you guys are not going to get a net of this kilogram. At level 4, you got 3 kilograms. So that's around 200 that you can make with a level 4 net. That's not bad, because I think that you need to pay 120 to come here. 100 to come here and 20 for each day. So after the first day, it's purely profit that you are going to make. So thanks for watching. Have fun. Bye bye.